petty no be coco. Now my party be the coco. See how the boy the shoto. See how the boy the shoto. The girls the follow. Poverty the bypass. Cause I stand the bypass. See how I make them high pass. If you see me now you see star. Poverty the bypass. Cause I stand the high pass. See how I make them high pass. If you see me now you see star.
Turn up, turn up, turn up. We're turning up right here on Joy 99.7 FM. This is the moment you've been waiting for. Kwame Eugene is in the building. Make some noise. You know how we do it on Joy. Yo, 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 yo. In a bit, I'm going to be speaking with the rock stars. So make sure you keep your dials locked right here on your superstation, Joy 99.7 FM. Now, before we go ahead to speak with our rock star, before we hang out with him, ask him all the questions that we've been thinking about since his inception. Yeah, go way back. I want to remind you that October on GoTV is full of endless and captivating drama. GoTV is the home of Europa and Conference League, so never miss a day with your favorite football stars. GoTV brings you boundless novelas. Watch Strange Love and Mariam Khan on Star Life, Perfect Husband and Money Merchants on Z-World, and Lolly's Luck on Telemundo. Then for more mind-blowing local series and movies, switch to Africa Magic Family or Africa Magic Epic or even Rock GH. Yearning for more football action? We've got you covered on Serie A, La Liga, EPL, the Dutch, Belgian and Scottish leagues. Rush now for your GoTV decoder, set at a reduced price of 89 Ghana cedis. To purchase a new decoder, SMS GoTV to short code 1731. Very simple. Or you can even download the My GoTV app and manage your account with ease. Terms and conditions do apply. GoTV, love it. And then Goil also has good news for you. Goil is rewarding its prepaying GoCard customers with 2 pesos discount per liter on fuels. You also enjoy discounts on lubricants at Goil stations nationwide. Elevate your goodness by joining Goil Go Club today and enjoy up to 3 pesos per liter discount on fuel, amazing discount on lubricant purchases, free life insurance cover provided by My Life Insurance. Accrue and contribute loyalty points to a social group to fund an approved CSR project, and above all, enjoy exclusive Goil branded campaign gift. Join the Goil Club now by visiting Goil stations or offices, or even their website, registration.goil.com.gh, and all Goil social media platforms. Individuals, corporate, family, and social groups, join the Goil Club now. Goil, good energy. Goil, yeah, yeah, DM. Now, have you heard about the Ultimate Plus One promo and special giveaways for applicants? Have you? Special giveaways happening on the rent-to-own day at the Joy News Habitat Fair on Saturday, the 30th of October, 2021, at the Accra International Conference Center. You heard it right here. Yeah, to rent-to-own by cities and habitats under the Plan City Extension Project. So grab your house and get an additional room under the rent-to-own land and house ownership scheme under the Plan City Extension Project. The steps to do this is to register and pick a voucher to get a special gift on the rent-to-own day. Get up to 5% discount on all properties and up to 30% discount on initial deposit and rent-to-own branded t-shirts. Remember, the terms and conditions do apply. Call or WhatsApp 055-55-30300 or 055-705-46935. Or you can visit newaccra.city on the internet or visit their Project Management Center, PMC, on the Central University campus, Miocho Inside from Pram. The Plan City Extension Project, shaping Ghana's urban future. Charlie, you ready? Are you ready for Kwame Eugene? Are you sure? I'm not sure. Pick your phones. Get on Twitter. We're using the hashtag DriveOnJoy. You can also hashtag Bunker. I want to put that message across. Hashtag Bunker. I'll tell you more about it a bit later on. But if you want to look smart and fashionable, I want you to visit any Wudin boutique nationwide today. Wudin offers an amazing collection of authentic African fabrics and ready-to-wear that come in beautiful designs and color for men and women. With Wudin, You can get creative and versatile with your designs. Be confident and show off how truly African you are in Wodeen. Visit any Wodeen boutique nationwide and choose from a variety of trendy African ready-to-wear styles from our latest collection, Tissage the Wodeen, to complement your unique style. Wodeen shops can be found at Accra Mall, ANC Mall, Junction Mall, Oxford Street, Osu, High Street, City Car Park Building. In Kumasi, you can find Wodeen shops at Kumasi City Mall and Idum Unicorn House. In Cape Coast, in the PAT Building near Kingsway. In Takoradi near Market Circle. In Koforidua in Antarctic Plaza Building. And in the PAT Building in Sunyane. Wodeen, le créateur. Chale Kwame, what's up? What's up? What's up? What's up? The rock star, the rock star, the rock star.
Wagwan.
Chale, Abiz, Abiz, what would you actually for your side?
Abiz.
So good to see you, man.
Anytime.
Hey, man. Now, Cross, you started in A1, was this your A2?
Ochra.
Hey, now, you used to swim with twice.
Oh, now, welcome.
Or Steven Amika. Now, go ahead with you.
You need some information.
On Joy FM, Charlie, every we are first in the news.
Mm-hmm.
First with the information.
Okay. So because that's like you're first with this very information, yeah?
You know, right?
Okay.
But hey, it's good to see you. Welcome to Drive on Joy 99.7 FM.
Thank you.
We've been looking forward to this. I posted this on my Twitter. It's been blazing up there. Everybody, you know, really looking out for this conversation, this hanging out with you, Kwame Eugene.
Yeah.
Into Waba, Yamuakwaba.
Yamuatrasi.
Kwame, how many songs do you have?
Quite a number of them.
Yes, how many? Can you give us, you know?
Kaka, I don't know Kaka. But I can't give you the vivid number.
But
I don't know the exact number. Not vividly, I can't do that. But I don't know Kaka.
500.
Hey, home. I find your daddy Lumba. Daddy Lumba near Machi de Mo.
Oh, yeah, sure.
Yeah.
300.
The starting chess. Probably, I think it's been 4 years, yeah.
Maybe a Seraton. When I opened the Seraton, there were so many songs.
I think it's the features that make my songs.
And I see some of them are also songs that you produced. So I was going to move on to even ask you that, how many songs have you also produced?
Yeah, I produce some songs in this country.
Right.
Yeah, some few big songs.
Oh, not a few big songs. I mean, you know, we're having this conversation backstage. You know,
small.
You keep saying small. Anyway, so our number, our WhatsApp number today, ladies and gentlemen, is 055-11-11997. We're hanging out with Kwame Eugene right here on Drive on Joy on Joy 99.7 FM. Kwame, this song, ehitie, shese ukaya.
Oh. Angela.
Oh, I see Angela.
Anywhere you there, I got it out. I said, I got it out. Baby, girl, you want to go after you. Baby, take my heart, baby, carry go. If you think I don't leave you, God forbid you. If you leave me, God, I will see you. You would have shown me things I can't resist, yeah, yeah. So I go mention your name to the whole wide world. So even you would have given me joy, Angela. Yeah, Angela.
Kwame, this song was a big hit. What was going through your mind when you were writing the song?
Nothing really. Yeah, this was just a hungry boy who wanted to survive.
Oh, but so, a hungry boy that wants to survive is thinking about something.
Angela, I'm just messing up. Don't mind me. Angela was like a gift to, I mean, a person called Angela. That's Richie Mensah's big sister. She reminded me for me saying this, but yeah, that's Richie Mensah's big sister, and it was like a gift to her.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so I remember it was her birthday, and that time Link signed me fresh. I don't get anything. Everybody was giving her gifts, and I was like, child, I don't have anything, Angie, but I wrote a song for you, and I'm sure that song will be very big. The whole world will sing your name. Before she was in the UK, she came back to Ghana, and Angela was everywhere. And I mean, even attacked her in the UK. Everywhere she passed, Angela. You know, Angela was being played in most places in the world.
Yes, of course.
Yeah, Angela did really good. So
yeah. Was that your first big song do you think that was your first big song?
I think that was what introduced me to the world. Even though Wish Me Well Confusion did magic, but then again, and Open Gate did magic as well, but then again,
no, but which of your Angela, songs hasn't Angela, done magic?
I know. Yes. Small.
You keep saying small. But what about this one?
Oh, that's a song. this is a song that actually cemented me being a limelight artist.
Oh, you think so?
I mean, after Angela, people were saying, you see these boys with one hit wonder, one hit wonder, he won't come again.
Right.
And boom, Confusion. That was when people were causing confusion. She was like, I was in line with everything that was going on. And I remember performing in Sierra Leone over 45,000 people. And this was a song they went crazy for. When they heard Confusion, everybody was singing, they're causing confusion. And it was a pretty sight.
And then we heard this one.
That's my favorite. That's my favorite song.
Do you have a favorite song?
Yeah, I have a favorite Kwame Eugene song.
And this is your favorite song?
Yeah.
Someone sends me the message and says, Wallahi is your favorite song.
This is my favorite song.
The NTA Gaga.
This part. Bum, 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 bum.
Did you produce this one?
Yeah, I produced this.
Did you play the guitars yourself?
Yeah, like, I did everything on this song.
Okay, so take us through a typical day inside the studio when you're doing your productions.
Okay, well, productions, like, when I'm producing a typical High Life song, like Wallahi,
right?
I love flute. So you hear
right.
Yes, that's what explains this song. And you know, our High Life used to have a lot of punches. I think in recent past we don't do them, but I like to still put them in my music. It makes it iconic.
Exactly.
Like pam 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 pam. That's what makes it iconic. Anytime you hear pam 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 pam, you know, okay, that's a Kwame Eugene song. Like.
So that's more like the signature to the song.
Yeah. So I think about my melodies and how it's going to sound to the next person and how to put my. So my kicks are normally not loud. My kicks are not loud.
Mild.
Yeah. You know, these days we are playing High Life with hard kicks, and it's not supposed to be like that.
Right.
High Life, they should enjoy the lyrics more and the melodies. It shouldn't be the kicks. Kicks are for hip-hop.
Hip-hop, right.
And dance on. So my kicks are normally not loud. And yeah, that's basically how I produce my music.
Wow, that's amazing. And I see that people are always trying to, feature you, and they always want you to be on the production as well.
Yeah.
One of the songs that I personally liked you were featured on was a song from DJ Vyroski. When I heard it the first time, I actually thought it was your song. And that's Adrimfi.
Oh, I produced this.
You produced this
as well? Yeah, I produced it. With the help of DJ Virus, can I say? Yeah, because he was in the studio, it was a whole vibe. Yeah.
How exactly did it go with this song, Adrimfi?
I think Adrimfi is was the song that I think I recorded Adrimfi even before Angela.
Oh, you don't mean it?
Yeah, I recorded Adrimfi even before Angela.
Whose concept was it?
Did he? It was my concept.
Okay, so how my come concept. It ended up being his song?
You know, Vyroski is like part of the Lynx family, so okay. He's normally around. So we're in the studio together, and I started this vibe. I was like, oh, this is hard. But then I had a song Lynx was about to release already, and Vyroski has that power to lay his hand on any song in the label and say, Chal, I want to own this song. So this was another piece he wanted to own, and I like the collaboration because Vyroski then had the access to Shatawale more than me. I wasn't close to Shata that much then. I was a new artist then. He will have to see. He'll have to listen to Vyroski more than me.
Right, right.
So he going to say, okay, I have a song with Kwame Eugene, I want you to be on, was an easy access to get to Shatawale. Yeah, and I was actually happy to have Shatawale on my song for the first time.
Of course.
And he actually mentioned my name, Shatawale Eugene. Kwame, and I was like, I was so recently I was there and I heard Adrimfi, and it got to Shatawale Eugene again. I remember how proud I was hearing Shatawale mentioning my name.
Well, that also moves me to my next question.
Yeah,
really want to find
shout
out.
Shout out to Shatawale.
Yo, shout out to Shatta movement.
He's
in that building.
Man.
So how has the transition been for you? You've mentioned a couple of times right now that you were a new artist, you were trying to survive, you had just been signed on to Lynx Entertainment. How exactly has the transition been for you, from being a new artist to being the rock star?
Quite a huge one, actually. Quite a huge one. I can mention a number of artists that I encountered, but then again, I wasn't big, so it wasn't a pretty one. I remember my first time meeting Sarkodie. I was like, whoa, that's Sarkodie. And Richie took me to Sarkodie. I was like, this is my new boy I'm about to sign. Can he get a picture? he wants a picture. I still have that picture.
You still do?
Yeah, I still do. And I sat close to Sarkodie. We took a picture together. I kept a picture. So I was so much in a hurry to post it for people to know
to
that. Shall I meet Sarkodie today? Yo, what's up? You get it? So I remember meeting, a lot of them. Dr. Crime. I used to go to events, pool parties to just go. I remember Miss V. Miss V used to come to Father Masala. Yeah, and I normally come there to watch Miss V and go home. I'm not lying about this. I come there, come and watch Miss V. You know, Links has a way of elevating an artist to make the artist.
We were having this conversation yesterday, yes. Myself and my
so
producer.
So I wanted to just see Miss V. So I'll see Miss V, and I remember laughing at myself recently that I was singing I'm a natural girl. I'm a natural boy. So I used to have some big time obsessions with some few artists out there even before I became big like them. So I give them that maximum respect.
Let me just switch over to one of the questions we're asking. This one is not really bad. But have you been dating any popular person in your mind? That's what we're asking our listeners today. in your mind. Or maybe, should I ask, you know, before you became a star, were you dating anyone in your mind?
No, they wouldn't date me.
No, I know. So were you dating them in your mind? Like,
oh,
you know,
no.
Nobody?
Me, I cut my coat according to my size.
Oh, so.
Yeah, man. I didn't have anything.
Okay.
What am I going to give you? What celebrity? Tally. I don't have anything for you.
So
now I might have something for you.
So now you're dating someone in your mind?
No. I'm still not
dating
anyone.
Come on. Are you sure?
I'm not going to. You know me. I'm very honest. I won't lie to you.
You're sure?
I'm actually not dating anyone.
Okay. So when people were actually, saying that you are going to be just a usual one-hit guy, and then you dropped Confusion, right?
Yeah.
What informed this song?
Oh, yeah.
Drive time. Joy 99.7 FM.
Yeah, baby, I need a car. I call him my provider. He be my protector. Somebody go higher. Yeah, baby, I need a car. I call him my provider. He be my protector. Somebody go higher.
What informed this song? Did it have anything to do with your enemies?
Actually,
obviously.
You know me, I don't lie to you. I'm not good at lying.
I want the truth.
I'm not good at lying. So the thing is, this was after Confusion. It was like, people thought Confusion wasn't going to be a hit because Angela, oh, these boys, they one hit normal call. And Confusion came. I thought Confusion was gonna shut people up. Then it doesn't work like that.
It was
that.
A joke.
Yeah. I feel now going Barbers. So people actually start saying more. And I remember sitting one Sunday, I went to my mom's and we were eating together and my mom don't usually see what goes on the internet. It's my sister, my big sister. I say, Ma, almost kwami, I see, almost kwami, I say, like, yo, stop giving the old woman headache.
Pressure,
man.
Yeah.
And I remember she replying, my sister is, kwami, if you ask, you'll be a baby any day, no, ko. But can you say, you'll be a baby, ni pabeka. E ya papa, omu beka.
Right.
E ya bonya, omu beka. Momo ka omu die, but boneno, emanen yeho, and move on. But can you say, you'll be a baby, ni pabeka. So on the table in my head, I was saying, yo, baby, I need Pabeka.
Oh,
but
wow.
I didn't tell her. I came home and I wrote Wish Me Well. I just wrote Wish Me Well.
Wow.
So Wish Me Well is, you see people say that, oh, when I'm bad, the song comes to me. When I'm in a shower, me doesn't do that. I write it.
You just write it.
Yeah, I didn't do it.
Did you go back to tell your mom that, mommy, that's it? You know, you helped me
I
write
I don't have to
this.
Thank her. She asked me, what kind of Thanksgiving again? We have to thank God for me.
Yeah, but did you give her credit? Did you give her credit?
She didn't write a song. She gave the idea.
Okay. So talking about you being,
she's aware. That was what brought up the
Oh, she's aware.
She's aware.
So she must be feeling proud. I mean, not necessarily
that's
as you
that's
being
not
an
her
artist.
Peace,
but
it's my piece. It's still her head.
Okay.
I'm sure she's listening and she's laughing in the house.
Oh, she should be laughing.
Okay,
so we're going to move from there, but I really want to ask you, what exactly have you learned so far, you know, about being an underground artist back then, and what advice would you give up-and-coming artists? Because you've made it from the very grassroots and now you are up high there.
Yeah, I think what I would say is being underground is not the same as being mainstream. It's so different from being mainstream. Being underground, I think you have the chance to make a lot of mistakes and correct them later. But now, it is like people expect perfection from you. You get it? I mean, there's some level of validation people are expecting, and once you don't meet their level of validation they want you to get to, it becomes a problem they have with you,
right?
And now people have numerous ways to express how they feel. Do you get it? So it's not easy. So I'm just telling every underground out there that this is the chance for you to make mistakes and correct them, because when you become Kwame Eugene, you have little chance
right,
to make mistakes and correct them.
Everyone wants
once
you
it
to.
Is out there, they judge you,
right?
But if you're underground and you put something out there, you can learn from that mistake. I shouldn't have done this song. Change the song. Even if it's out there. Mm. But now, I can't put Banker out there tomorrow and say, no, you people, unlisten to Banker. I'm bringing another one. That's why some level of validation is expected from us.
Right.
People expect you to be perfect to some level.
Yes.
So you come with a song, they expect it to be a hit. Thanks to God that, I release and it's a hit song. But I'm not a magician.
Mm-hmm.
I don't have any divine powers that I can tell this is going to be it. I try my luck.
Yeah,
and thank God it just
shines,
works.
Right.
But if it doesn't work, I don't have anything to do about it. Because a lot of people are doing it and it's not working. Mm. It's not their fault. They are in the limelight. So once they make the mistakes, they can't correct it anymore.
Right, right. Yeah. Kwame, you're a hard worker. You've progressed, you know, from being an underground artist. And then coming up, you came up with this beautiful work of art on one of your albums. You call it Showbody.
Ooh. This music is sweet.
Mm. You played this yourself as well?
No, Richie did this.
Okay.
I even said it in a song. And you are listening to a Richie Mensah instrumental. I said it. Mm. Oberti.
Drive time on Joy 99.7 FM.
Ooh, I like music. I like music. See where I go, where I show. Where I slim, where I fat. Where I like skin or melanin. Baby, step in a circle and dance to the beat. Where I'm Angelique, yo. Monica Benedicta Ocaro. Oh, baby, my Sherry Coco. Baby, step in a circle and dance to the beat. Showbody. No, the Richie part is coming. Don't worry. I want you to listen to the Richie part. This is a senior man production. And you are dancing with the Richie Mensah instrument.
Oh!
Yeah, my place is DJ Boom Boom. The only way a rock star don't be Boom Boom.
Kwame, sometimes do you throw shit, foul? That's what I'm asking. Sometimes you throw shade.
This shade was actually for a particular presenter.
Uh-huh.
I was on her show. It's a female. Uh-huh. I was on her show. And I was like, oh, yeah, fair rock star. No, met nasty. I came to sit down. Nah, then I found rock star. I was like, wow, really?
Serious. This one is not straight bullet.
And I'm saying, with my phone. So I went to the studio when I was writing this. I said, you are really with a real rock star. No, be the one in the gungun bag. Do you get it?
Yeah.
I started saying rock star even before gungun bag came. But then again, I don't know. I'll be rock star now. And I said, no, you are listening to a real rock star. No, be the one in the kungun. Yeah.
So
that's the meaning of that line there.
Anyway, so I'm going to ask you something about Richie. But before that, this is a song from the Son of Africa album.
Yeah.
And I really want to find out, you know, what informed the creation of this album?
Okay, so this album is basically inform the rest of the world that there is one guy in Africa that most people cherish so much. Mm. I've moved from that street boy to become a mainstream artist,
right,
and move to the level where every African probably sees me like a family member.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm like a son to the whole of Africa.
Mm.
Do you get it? Because everybody enjoys my music.
Mm.
Yeah. That was basically the idea of the whole, Son of Africa album.
And
it was an introduction to the world.
To the world, but it did really good.
Very good.
And one of the very popular songs on this particular album, the third track on the album, is this.
Oh, Hopinge. Prime
time.
My mommy, but everybody has to hear what I have to say. My baby,
woo,
pretty, pretty lady. Oh, my sexy lady, I can't wait for our wedding. And on that day, happy birthday goes to the sooner, the sooner, sooner.
Great song, great song.
Yeah, yeah.
Like we said, I don't think you have a song that is bad. I don't think so, and that's really commendable. You see, did Richie do anything on this particular song?
This song was actually produced by three people. Myself, Willis Beat, Richie Mensah.
Oh, wow.
Yes.
Willis Beat was actually on this?
Yeah.
Wow.
Willis did the preamble of it.
Okay.
He did the basics.
Okay.
And I did the mid part of it.
Okay.
Added some few beats and did the arrangement.
And then went to the boss.
The
boss himself. Right.
Yeah.
Right. So what's your relationship with Richie apart from him being your boss?
He's one person I admire so much. He's a mentor.
Mm.
Yeah, he's always been a mentor. It was my dream to meet Richie. But I didn't just get to meet him. I got to work with him. So I'm just glad being with Lynx Entertainment. And Richie, as a matter of fact, has been my mentor and I always love seeing him. I just always be very friendly, look at Richie and smile like, wow, I'm really working with Richie.
Yeah.
I love him so much.
Do you think you're ever going to leave Lynx Entertainment?
I think so. I'll probably die and leave.
Hey, that's the punchline. That's the punchline. Please,
yeah,
write it down for me. It's going straight on to myjoyonline.com. So you think you're going to be there forever?
I don't know, but I love Lynx Entertainment.
Mm.
Maybe it will shock you guys. I'll have a baby and me and Richie will be going to PTA meetings together.
So does that also mean that, well, it could happen that maybe sometime in the future you can own some shares with, you know, in
it
Lynx
would be
Entertainment?
Bad. If he would even sell Lynx to me, I'll buy it.
Oh, but then if he sells it to you, then it means you're not working with him anymore.
I don't even have the money to buy it now. But maybe one day.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, I just love Lynx so much. And I think it's really important is the relationship we have.
Yeah.
The fact that they've been able to, accept me as Eugene as I am, and being able to work with, because I'm a stubborn guy. I'm really stubborn.
Mm.
I like to do
Fadama boy.
Yes, I just love to do what I think is good for me.
Mm.
And sometimes maybe something will be good for me, but it's not good for Lynx.
Mm-hmm.
They have to maneuver their way around it to make it. I mean, to explain to me that we have to do this first before this before. Oh, well, then I understand. I'm very stubborn, but my level of comprehension is actually close. I admit it. As I must say, once you can explain to me, this is the reason why we are doing this, I'm good.
Mm.
So I think they've been able to put up with me for a very long time now, and I have to commend them for that. Shout out to Lynx Entertainment. Shout out to Richie Mensah. He's a very good man, and I appreciate wherever
he's done
I am right now, because he's the reason why I'm here. I appreciate him so much. And leaving Lynx will be quite difficult, but I mean, I'm just telling you, one day.
Well, I agree.
Maybe I'll be too old
to leave.
Or maybe he would go like, oh, watch it. To
go.
Yeah.
But what do you think makes Lynx Entertainment artists very successful in their careers? We had an interesting conversation yesterday, myself.
I'm about to say something very honest, though.
Okay, please go ahead.
I don't know if people will like it or they won't like it.
Mm.
Ask your question again, let me answer. Yeah.
I said, what makes Lynx Entertainment artists very successful?
I'm about to tell you the truth.
Tell me.
Richie won't like it, I'm saying. If he's listening, say like, hey, what is he about to say? Okay, so I think the reason why Lynx Entertainment, every artist that comes to Lynx Entertainment becomes successful with this music thing is Richie knows how to handpick talents.
Mm-hmm.
That's one thing he knows. He can tell whether you fail or you make it.
Oh, wow.
Yes.
He can just look at you the first time. Or
he can listen to you, look at how you talk, how you walk, and go like, no, they won't like this person. I don't have to spend money on
so
him.
So it's not even just the talent.
He has
but
that
also
foresight. That's why he's called Lynx. Lynx is a cat that sees far from what everyone is seeing. That's why he's called Lynx. He understands. He can tell, okay, this boy will blow. This person won't blow. And this is the secret he wouldn't want people to know. But I'm going to meet him in the office that he will say. But then again, I think that's why every artist that comes to Lynx makes it. He knows how to handpick talents. Yeah.
So my producer is having, you know, we've spoken extensively about Lynx.
Yeah.
So there is a certain trend, okay, whether you agree with me or not. I don't want to mention names, but if you take a look at most of the artists who have been on Lynx and exited, it becomes very difficult for them to maintain that level of success, okay?
You think so?
Well, yes. Okay. You don't think so?
I don't think so.
You don't think so? You don't think the careers of the artists that have left Lynx
has
taken a nosedive?
Well, maybe you see it as such, but to them, they are blowing.
Kwame. So what about in your head? Because if we activate the phones right now, people are going to say the same thing. This
because
is,
people
this
are
is public
in their
knowledge
of their homes and they can say anything they want. I think they've all made it to the level they probably want to make it to. Let's not attack anybody, please.
I hear Kwame. We're going to take a listen to your very new song whilst we enjoy this one. If you put your body on me,
but no, no, we're blue. We're not 99.7 FM. If you put your body on me, then I put my money on you. I put my dollar on you, girl. Oh, girl, you're looking so amazing. For you.
We're still hanging out with the rock star Kwame Eugene. Song in the background currently is Doll on You. If you don't have money, then I'm sorry. Kwame Eugene is going to make it rain on you. Kwame, I know you have a new EP coming out. What do you call it?
Afro High Life EP.
Afro High Life EP. Yeah. What informed it? I think it's not yet released, but you have one song out and people are going to love it.
Yeah.
What informed this EP?
The EP has a fusion of Afrobeat and High Life music because I'm trying to come up with a genre that represents me so well. But then again, I mean, I love High Life and I've been tagged with High Life for a very long time, which I'm very proud of. I'm super proud of. But you know, we can't put away the fact that Afrobeat is what is crossing the borders at the moment.
That's true.
That is
it's
why
going international.
Most of my colleagues are saying they are doing Afrobeat because it's not their fault. They're for chop. They want to go international. And me too, I want to go too. So I figured, you know what? Let me come up with a journal that supports what I do already, but then again, have a fusion of what is trending at the moment.
Right. So
I
the
came
best
up
of
with
both worlds.
Afro High Life EP, and it has a combination of Afrobeat and High Life. It's a fusion of the both. So that is what I'm heading towards. So the EP will come out, and you see all the five songs has a connection of what I'm talking about.
Wow.
So it is Banker that is out at the moment, but you can go on Apple Music and pre-save it.
Yes,
so you can see.
I did that yesterday.
Thank you so much. People are pre-saving.
Yesterday.
Thank you. You're part of the number of people that are pre-saving.
I can show you. I did it.
A lot
yesterday.
Of people are pre-saving it. So it comes out on the 12th of November and you get an alert that you get to listen to the EP first.
And then what is Bunker about before we drop?
Bunker is about a place I basically feel safe when I am. You know, I mean, the regular meaning for Bunker is a place that I feel safe when I did. So yes, the song is saying, I did this song. Now, because of you, we have dropped this banger.
Right.
I'm in a comfortable lead. From the top to the under, I do feel safe when I'm in that bunker. Rockstar, bang, 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 bang.
New one from Kwame Eugene, Bunker.
We didn't come here to play.
Am I the only one running on the floor? Cause you're waiting patiently for my downfall. The money gone like an uncle. I'm in the mud, they fight at the stand tall. Passing my balcony. All of the girls wanna follow me. More money, more enemies, but you will never know peace if you want to kill my vibe. Die by fire, my vibe. Oh, die by fire, hey, my vibe. Die by fire, my vibe. Die by fire. Stronger, not because of you, where I drop this banger. Comfortable lead from the top. Top to the
body wanna carry go. Inni mini money mo. Slim fat tall and a heavy load. I mean I don't know why they want to do it though. Get fame and no eyes on you. Pretty girls see me and they all confused. French girls say you know the vibe on you. So confused. Cash in my balcony. All of the girls wanna follow me. More money, more enemies. But you will never know peace if you want to kill my
vibe. By fire.
My
vibe.
Die
by fire.
What's that thing you're saying in there?
Vibe.
Mm-hmm.
Die
by
fire. My
vibe.
So die. By fire,
I don't get it. You're
stronger.
Saying
now because of you, I drop this banger. Comfortable lead from the top to the under. I don't feel safe when I'm in that bunker, 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 bunker.
Vibe, vibe, and it's live here on Drive on Joy with me, Kofi Hayford. We're hanging out with Kwame Eugene. Chale Kwame, it's been amazing hanging out with you.
Yeah.
This is a song that really people should go and check.
Mm-hmm.
I just want you to put out the information for them once more before we leave.
Hi, what's up, it's your rock star, Kwame Eugene. So Banker is out there off my son, Afro High Life. You see, Son of Africa is still in my head.
Congratulations, Son of Africa.
I think it's made 20 million views on Boom, 20 million streams on Boom Play already.
Oh, wow.
So congratulations,
amazing.
Son of
Congrats.
Africa. So, up to my new EP, Afro High Life EP, please. Banker is out there. You can go check on Banker. Go jam to it. And that's a song people are playing. Everyone is playing at the moment. Shout out to Joy FM. Shout out to my friends. Shout out to Ghanaians for holding me down. I appreciate the love. It's your rockstar, Kwame Eugene. Go check on Banker right now. We didn't come here to play.
We didn't come here to play. Tali, thank you so much for coming.
Anytime,
by. We're going to support you every now and then.
Bless you.
Thank you so much.
Bye.
Hello, waiter. Please bring the beer. Okay, guys.